So when we last left off in the last video, still the same day, Sunday, in the last video, Melissa had gone to sleep and she had given me permission to keep playing. And I said I would put on House MD, you know, Dr. House. If you're watching this in the distant future, it's a medical show about a doctor who is addicted to Vicodin. And he's a genius, and he's tortured, and blah blah blah. Anyways, don't want to be too loud. But she doesn't seem to mind me practicing, so... I've made so many videos this weekend since I got this guitar fixed. And just as when I got it in tune for the first time, I started playing more. I've wanted to play more since I've got it. It's like, it's pretty much 100% right now, like correct. And it's a good feeling, and I like to play it, and I like the sound. And I guess the only step above is to, like, buy a better guitar, which I don't want to do, but I have been thinking about, and I don't have the money for. But anyways, yeah, so we're in a good place. And I just took my lithium. I was pretty wide awake after taking my final anxiety call of the day. I think I am a bit stuffed up, I might have a cold. So I took my final anxiety call of the day, and I was still awake, and so I had a Coke, and then I had another Coke, and then I had a coffee, and then I had another coffee. And now I have my lithium and my cogentin. My cogentin is a muscle relaxant. But apparently it also has psychoactive effects, which I'm not clear of. Melissa said something about the distortion of time. And it's the last day of the month. In 38 minutes, I will be 8 months sober for Yemi. Yeah, I'm just rambling, so I'm gonna move on. I legitimately heard a voice in my head, like your stereotypical schizophrenic voice in head, which my psychiatrist told me does not necessarily make me a schizophrenic, which is very nice of her to say. But yeah, I heard that like in the spring, so like 6 months ago. And since then I've just been exploring the idea, or like thinking about it a lot. So anyways, I heard a voice, and by this, when I say I heard a voice in my head, and it sounds pretentious. I'm going to use the word poetry. I'm not, like, capital P poetry. I just mean, like, I'm using metaphor, simile. I felt a response. I had a thought response. It's not a voice. I didn't hear anything. Why is this so hard to explain? So, I felt a thought response to my verbal statement, I don't even know where I am. And the thought response was, Ben, you're in heaven. Like, you've got a perfectly tuned guitar, perfectly set up, the neck's not bent or anything. You have a fairly good grasp of playing the guitar. You have a beautiful girlfriend sleeping in your bed, who you can join. You can join now, I mean. I mean to hold, obviously, the mount. I can hold anything evil. but I could go hold her right now, but I'm awake. But I could fall asleep. And I have the guitar. But anyways, the point is, the response to I don't even know where I am, I'm in heaven. And when I thought I'm in heaven, my next thought like jumped to take a clonazepam. And according to my own rules, which keep me like it's an addictive drug, and according to my own rules, which keep me from getting addicted, I hope you can hear me over the air purifier. So I'm not supposed to take another one until 8 a.m., so another 8 and a half hours. And I want to take one just to be like, damn, like, you know when you have a good day, you're like, damn, this is a good day. And I guess in the past, if I was having a good day and I was a drinker, I would be like, damn, that was a good day, here's another beer, you know, like, so, I have that urge, I'm gonna fight that, and I'm getting sleepy, which you can probably tell by my voice, but this is a guitar video, I should shut up. I'm in heaven and I have all these, I can hug and fall asleep, can take a pill, like all these ways to make myself feel happier, and play guitar, which is what I'm doing. Like, can you make mistakes in heaven? Like, once you get to heaven, like obviously I'm on earth, but like theoretically if there is a heaven, I have no idea. Like, yeah, there's pictures you see as a kid of what heaven looks like. And as a kid, they're like, yeah, this is a picture of heaven, but this isn't actually what heaven looks like. Or something, I don't know, something like that. But I didn't read the Bible, so I don't know. But, I may be falling asleep in the chair, so I'm just sitting here. I don't know. I don't know where I was, but I was just warming up with the simple chords, and I don't think I obtained them all, that's what I call it, or that's what I'm calling it right now. I don't think I hit all the chords that are on my chart, but, oh, I totally didn't do G, okay. Mm-hmm. see this. Okay. Now, as for this chart, this is my cage lesson. And they say, when you're too tired, you don't learn. I guess I'm kind of tired, but I'm also drugged, and I'm guessing if you're drugged, you don't learn. If you do learn, you learn very slowly. But I have the feeling this is like the fourth hour I've been practicing in the past 24 hours. I don't know. I haven't counted. It doesn't matter. But if it was the fourth hour, this would be the most I've practiced in one day. Which both suggests that I'm healthy and, something else. Happy and healthy? I sometimes play the guitar to become happy. I don't know. I wonder what if I start writing songs and I've been, you know, fooling around with the basic chords. I think like these chords I'm learning right now are the ones that I really want to be playing with, but I start writing songs. I doubt I'll be like a depressed Elliott Smith type. I don't know why I bring that up. I don't know why I bring him up. I guess because he died at 33, so all the other rock stars that I could think of are either like Eric Clapton, who's, you know, fair enough, good on him, but I don't listen to him. And all the people who died at 27. And then all the indie people who no one cares about. So maybe I could be like part of them, but I don't know. Anyways, my point is I don't think I will be like someone who dwells on depression. But at the same time, I don't think I will be like super manic happy. Although I think I could be. I think we could have a like happy manic song, but I don't think like all my songs, you know, don't count your chickens before they're hatched, is what I should say. Like, look at me puffing up. To even get this chord. Yeah, that's not perfect. Okay, major problem. Today's November 30th, and the major problem with almost all of my videos from today, or even yesterday, is like, my friend told me, I've got a properly working guitar now, and so I don't have to, like, dig for the notes. And when my guitar, like, it's amazing, I had no idea, I was a new guitar player, but I had no idea how badly my guitar needed to be fixed, and the way it was before, I had to really like fight to get the sound, like strum hard and push hard, and my friend basically told me, like, so the strings are like, I asked for medium, but I don't know, they're low. They seem low to me. I guess they could be lower. Anyways, my friend said, like, with a guitar set up like mine, you want to play as lightly as possible. And the harder you play, like, it's okay at this volume, but at a higher volume, when I like really dig into the sixth string, gives a bad sound. So you want to play lightly, and if you want it to be louder, turn up the amp. And I have had the amp at a very low level. And, yeah. So anyways, of course I've got volume control here. So I'm just learning to adjust from like fighting with it and pushing hard and playing hard to just like being really light with it. So that's part of what I'm learning, in addition to the chords themselves, of course. Same way, like, I could think, like, am I too quiet? Like, I need to be quiet because there's somebody asleep just over there who doesn't, like, she falls asleep with the television on. Anyways, I need to be quiet, and I think, like, am I being too quiet for the camera? And I've noticed in previous videos I'm probably too loud for the camera, but I, like, most people watching this video would instinctively know how to adjust the volume, if, like, I assume. I assume anyone who uses YouTube, like, at least 99% are familiar with the volume function. So, yeah. Reminds me of, like, there's this podcast, and they said the podcast volume was too low, and the guy who ran the podcast was like, buy better speakers. And so I'm not going to be like that. That's a really mean thing to say to someone who watches your stuff, but yeah, anyways, I'll just show you. Those bucks, that gave me like a wind of energy. I felt like it woke me up, like, I don't know, I'm not gonna get dramatic and like write a poem to my guitar. So now we're on B, or A actually. We're on A, and we're playing A major, okay. For some reason, no, okay, this is B, to be a major. Let's say a major. Okay. So wait, if we go a major. D major. Doesn't matter. I was just seeing how the progression goes. Okay, so yeah, let's do the roots for B or for A. That's the sound I was talking about before when playing too hard. Let's sit up a bit. Just thinking about that. That ween. Dean ween. Saying, whatever you do, don't block your penis when you play the guitar. And he's like, I can't explain why, you just have to trust me. And so I'm blocking your penis right now, so I guess I'll stop doing that. Such a fun shape. This guy on Facebook.